Welcome to Tuesday, September 15th. I'm Pastor Jim Krieger from Holy Cross Lutheran Church and School in Saginaw, Michigan, celebrating God's holy word with you today in our daily devotion. These words of Jesus, recorded in John 14, verse 1, a timeless lesson of truth. Let not your heart be troubled. These words from Jesus have comforted multitudes of God's people for nearly 2,000 years. Neither the things of this world that darken our lives, nor the imaginations of the heart that cloud our mind, ever shift our focus and trust in these words of comfort from our Savior Jesus. Jesus spoke these words mere moments after describing to Peter how he would betray the Son of God, and not so long before Jesus would be arrested, convicted, and crucified. These words of comfort were spoken by Jesus, even though he knew he would soon face rejection, betrayal, false accusations, an unjust trial, and the weight of the sin of the whole world on his shoulders. The cross and its torment lay before him. He also knew that in his own darkest hour, the very face of his beloved Heavenly Father would turn away from him, and the full measure of his Father's wrath and abandonment would come to bear because Jesus was made to be sin for us. The disciples were certainly troubled because they could not understand why Jesus would say such things. Jesus had repeatedly shared with them that he would soon be leaving them, and that knowledge left them troubled and distressed. But then the Lord Jesus spoke those grace-filled words of comfort and encouragement to their unsettled hearts and minds, caring and loving words that have echoed down through the centuries of time. Let not your hearts be troubled. The Messiah, the Master, the Teacher they deeply loved, was to be taken from them after suffering the most unimaginable and cruel treatment. Their hopes were dashed to the ground, and they must certainly have wondered who they would turn to in the future. And into this darkness of doubt and their unending questions, Jesus assured them, as he assures us today, let not your hearts be troubled. They had anticipated that Jesus was soon to set up his kingdom on earth. They expected to be given places of responsibility, but instead, they would be witnesses to the single greatest and most significant event of all time, the Son of God offering himself willingly as the ransom price for the sins of all people. But not only did Jesus instruct them, "Do not let your hearts be afraid," but he revealed the way to the peace they would need in the days to come. Words of peace that would meet them in their time of worry and fear. Believe in God, believe also in me. Just as they had trusted in the Lord, the Almighty God, they trusted in Jesus, the Word made flesh, who was with God in the beginning, and through whom all things were made. Jesus was not only the Messiah of Israel, the Son of the living God, but he was God, the Son, the incarnate Word, in whom are the words of eternal life. We live in a world filled with so many stresses and strains and growing uncertainties, and although we are not able to prevent these and even more pressures of life from overwhelming us, we have these words of certain assurance from the Lord Jesus himself, because he overcame the world, the devil, and our own sinful flesh. And through saving faith in him, we are conquerors. We share in his victory on the cross over sin and through the grave over death. Victories that help us overcome the many challenges and troubles we face in this sinful world. We may be living in some of the darkest days of our lifetimes, but there will be a new dawn of joy for us as well. And on that glorious day, when Jesus comes from heaven again to take us to be with him, do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. believe also in me. Let us pray. Dearest Jesus, thank you for your words of comfort. Thank you for coming to earth to bring peace to our hearts, healing to our soul, and life to our spirit. Enable us in the power of the Holy Spirit to hold fast to the wonderful truths in your word. And I pray that you fill each one of us with the wisdom, the words, and the grace to share your comfort with all those we meet who are facing their own challenges, troubles, and disappointments. All this and more I lift up in your precious name, even as I now lift to my Father's throne the prayer you taught me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor, and in the very name of Jesus, may you have peace in these words. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me.